Hi, and welcome back to PR Tech Talk. Digital temperature sensors, or DTS for short, is one of the features in the new microcontrollers from ST. And I thought that we should take a look at it and create a project and see how we handle with the DTS. So take along. We start by starting the STM32Q IDE and update the latest version. And here we have now started the target selection, and I selected the microcontroller for the application today, and I chose the STM32H563 for this example. And as you can see here, we have that in under the analog section, we have the ADC and the DAX, and in the ADC you as always have the internal temperature sensor there. As well with the VDD BAT sensors, internal sensors. But you also have a digital sensor, and that is what we are going to take a look in today. So it's here, the digital temperature sensor. So we select that board. We have it here in the Nucleo H563 set I. And just next, and we give it a name. And we can just hit finish. So this is a new feature for the Cube IDE, and at least I haven't seen it before. So it's for the human machine interface. So that is the commonly known or the commonly used LED 1, 2 and 3 that is available on the board, and the user button, and also virtual COM port. So it asks us if it would like to generate this from the very beginning, and yeah. Right, why not? So we just hit OK there. Here we get an ask a question about the iCache. I say that I would like to proceed to generate the code, but I will also enable the iCache. Great, so the first thing is going under the system core, and here we have the iCache. So we just enable that one. The next thing that I would like to go into is the clock configuration. And I'm changing the main clock to 100 megahertz. So there it found a solution for the 100 megahertz, and it uses the high speed external here. And go through the PLL and goes out here to the H clock, and that also then source all these P clocks, P clock 1, 2 and 3. So we have 100 megahertz there, and that is good to know. So we then go under the pins and configuration, and we can go under analog, and there we have the DTS, like so, and we hit activate. Here we can see that it has a couple of configuration, not much. Reference clock selection, it have then the high speed clock reference, the P clock, or the low speed external. But we will like to use the P clock, so the high speed. And there are two modes that you can use this DTS, and that is with or without calibration. And if you use the low speed external, then you don't have any calibration. So that is the reason for me selecting the high speed. So I disable the quick measurement. So I can't make any quick measurement. I can only make the normal one. The sampling time, I will choose 10 cycles. The more cycles, the more accurate it is. And I said that we had 100 megahertz for the P clock, and this peripheral create or demands 1 megahertz input, so I put a divider here for 100. And that is what I need to do here, so I hit this device configuration tool generation, and it generates all the initialization code for me. So if we take a look in this one, then we can see here that we have the MX DTS initialization done, and we also have the iCache there. That is mainly for performance. And we can also see that it has initialized all the LEDs for us. And it also have the button, user button, and also the COM port. And so that is the virtual COM port that you have on the USB connector. And down here we have the while one loop, nothing happens. So we can't expect anything to happen at this point. So we just hit build option. And it built without any errors, and that is what we expect. Now we need to write some code. So I go here under while one loop, and we have this HAL DTS start. So here is where we start the peripheral. And it also needs a handler, so that is the HDTS, and that is declared up here. There we have that one. So that is already declared. So what this does, it just tests if it starts okay, and if it don't start, then it goes to the error handler. But we don't expect anything to go wrong here. So that is when we started. The next step is that we need to make the measurement, and you will get the temperature in degrees Celsius and without any decimals. So it's the same here. If HAL DTS get temperature and the handler again, and where to store the information, that is in under a variable called the temperature. And if it's not HAL OK, then it will get to the error handler. Then we need to output this something, and we just use the printf because we have already installed when we created the project the printf function for us. So I just install the temp, and then I have this variable temperature, which I populate in this application there. And when that is done, we can do like this so that we can stop the peripheral. So we do HAL DTS stop and the handler again, and we just make an error correction or error test if there is any problems with stopping it. And since we are in the main loop, we need to have some delay, otherwise it will go so fast that everything will crash. So I will put in a delay of 1000 milliseconds, that is 1 second. And so from the very beginning it will start, and it will get a temperature, and it will print, and then it will stop it, and then it will wait 1 second, and then it will return again. So we build a project and hope that there is nothing error. Okay, of course, the temperature that we have here is not declared. That is that need to be declared as well. So we go here under user code begin private variables. Oops, like that. We build application, and there were no errors and no warnings, so we try to debug it. Cannot be launched, there are no recent launches, okay. So we go under debug configuration, and we hit new. And under the debug, we hit the serial wire, and we scan for the ST-link and apply that one. So now it found the debugger, and it downloads it to the microcontroller. So now it's downloaded. We also now need to have a terminal program, so I will use the TerraTerm. Okay, so now I have the TerraTerm, and I have selected the correct COM port and also the correct baud rate. So we can now hit run here. And we see immediately that the temperature is reporting once a second. And if I heat it up and I have a small heat source here, And now let's see what's happening. So we can see that the temperature is rising quite rapidly. So this was the DTS, and it's an easy installation and easy to use. So if you learn something now, give it a thumbs up. And if you're not a subscriber yet, please consider to do so. And if you have any comments to me, please leave it in the notes field below. So until I see you next time, stay safe.